So in the last section, you noticed that our random action returns action result. This action result is the base class for all action results in ASP.NET MVC. So depending on what an action does, it will return an instance of one of the classes that derive from action result. In our random action, we're calling this view method here, which is just a helper method inherited from the base controller class. This method allows us to quickly create a view result. Alternatively, we can return a view result like this. Return new view result. You can see that it's easier to just call the view method, and this approach is way more common amongst ASP.NET MVC developers. Now you might be asking, why is the return type of this method action result, even though we're actually returning a view result? Well, in case of this action, we could simply set the return type to view result. And this is actually a good practice, especially when it comes to unit testing this action. This way, we'll save ourselves from an extra cast in our unit tests. We'll look at unit testing in the second part of this course. But sometimes it's possible that in an action, we may have different execution paths and return different action results. In that case, we need to set the return type of that action to action result so we can return any of its subtypes. Okay, view result is one of the action results that you work with most of the time. Let's take a look at other types of action results. We have partial view result to return a partial view, content result to return simple text, redirect result to redirect the user to a URL, redirect to route result to redirect to an action instead of a URL, JSON result to return a serialized JSON object, file result to return a file, HTTP not found result to return a not found or 404 error, an empty result which is used when an action doesn't need to return any values, like void. As you can see, for all these types except empty result, we have a helper method in the base controller class. So let's see some of these in action. Back in the code, I'm going to comment this out. Let's return content, like hello world. Let's run the application with control and F5. And navigate to /movies/random. So look, we just get plain string content in the response. Another example, let's return HTTP not found. Now build the application with Control-Shift-B. This will compile the application without opening a new tab in the browser. Now press Alt and Tab to switch back to Chrome and Control-R to refresh the page. Okay, look, we got the standard 404 error. Now for empty result, we don't have a helper method. So if you want to create an action that doesn't return anything, you need to return an instance of empty result like this. Return new empty result. Control-Shift-B to build. Alt and Tab. Control-R. Okay, look, there's nothing in the response. And the last example. Return redirect to action. Here we specify the name of the action and then the controller. Now sometimes as we are redirecting the user from one page to another, we need to pass arguments to the target action. To pass arguments, we use an anonymous object as the third argument to this method. So new anonymous object, let's say page is one, and sort by is name. Build. Back to Chrome. Refresh. Okay, look, we got redirected to the homepage. And you can see in the browser address bar that the arguments we sent are appearing as part of the query string. So this is pretty much all you need to know about action results. By the way, don't think you need to memorize any of this stuff. For the most part, you'll be using view, HTTP not found, and redirect result.